So here we have an oversimplified example of a cell sitting at a typical resting membrane potential of minus 70 millivolts. The membrane potential is the difference in voltage between the inside and outside of the cell, and that membrane potential depends on the concentration gradient of ions between the inside and outside of the cell, and also which ion channels and how many ion channels happen to be open. So looking just at sodium and potassium ions, we can see that the normal concentration gradient for sodium is to have more sodium outside the cell than inside, and for potassium, it's normal to have more potassium inside the cell than outside. So if we consider what would happen when we open a sodium channel. So if we take a sodium channel and some ligand binds with the gate to open it, or maybe a change in voltage opens it, then you would probably predict that sodium would move into the cell based on its concentration gradient, moving from high to low concentration, and you would be right. The question is, when would sodium stop entering the cell? And the answer is it would stop when the membrane potential reaches plus 60 millivolts. So sodium will never reach its chemical equilibrium, because once the cell reaches plus 60 millivolts, it is positive enough to repel any further entry of sodium ions. And so we call that the equilibrium potential of an ion, which is the voltage that exactly offsets the chemical concentration gradient. So let's operate our sodium potassium ATPase and reset our ion gradient. And now we're back to our resting membrane potential of minus 70 millivolts and a normal concentration gradient for sodium. Now what would happen if we open a potassium channel? If you predicted that potassium would leave the cell following its concentration gradient, you would be exactly right. And it would leave the cell until the cell became minus 90 millivolts. And this is because minus 90 millivolts is the equilibrium potential for potassium. That's the membrane voltage that holds on to any potassium ions that would have a tendency to leave the cell, because negative attracts positive. So when you open an ion channel, we say that the membrane potential approaches the equilibrium potential of that ion, because it may never get there based on the concentrations of other ions in there, and it depends how long the ion channel is left open for. But when we open a potassium channel, we say the membrane potential approaches minus 90 millivolts, but it can't go lower. And when we open sodium channels, we say the membrane potential approaches the equilibrium potential of sodium, but it certainly couldn't go any higher than that. So if you know the normal concentration gradients for ions, so you need to know sodium, potassium, calcium, and chloride, and you know the equilibrium potentials of those ions, then you are armed with the knowledge to predict the change in membrane potential that would happen if you open any of those ion channels. And that is all you need to know to understand how graded potentials and action potentials work, and understand how neurons and other excitable cells send electrical signals.